Founded in 1853, Cheltenham Ladies College in England is one of the oldest girls' schools in the world. It was established to provide a sound academic education for girls, which would enable them to take their place in the world as confident and independent young women. And as Robin Ross reports, its generations-old ethos is very much in tune with today's IB philosophy.
Since 1853, Cheltenham Ladies College has been at the forefront of the education of girls. Always striving to stay connected to the changing world, the college introduced the International Baccalaureate in 2008, alongside offering A-levels. It's regarded as an alternative to A-levels. Girls take six subjects, three at standard level, three at higher level, allowing a greater breadth of learning.
That was one of the reasons I actually chose to do the IB, so I could keep learning a language and doing sciences and the humanities, along with being able to do CAS and my extracurriculars. And I think it has made me more of a well-rounded person.
You know, we're expected to have five careers within our lifetime, so as many subjects as possible to sort of help me with that transition would be very much appreciated.
Cheltenham Ladies College has a strong traditional British identity, but embraces global values.
The vision for education at Cheltenham Ladies is to embody excellence, independence, inspiration and empowerment in the education of women. The international mindedness, the reflective practice and the intellectual breadth ideally suit many of our students. They love that opportunity to study maths and English and a language and science as well as other subjects.
And its popularity is picking up pace. Until recently, IB was only taught in a minority of independent schools, but is now an option in some state schools too. It's currently on offer at 190 schools in the country. But some parents worry that with so much breadth, there is little depth. Jackie Adams helped to introduce the diploma and teaches IB physics.
Now I teach girls who are still scientists, they're doing higher level physics, chemistry, maths, but they're coming from an English class or a philosophy class or a history class. And having scientists who can communicate and think in a different perspective, I think creates better scientists.
I like to do medicine at university, so it was really important to me that I could keep two higher level sciences going at the same time. And although A-level I would have been able to do exactly the same thing, I also really enjoy English and I wanted to take that to a higher level as well.
As the girls navigate their way through life, the IB helps them to think independently. CAS is a compulsory part of the diploma. It encourages creativity, activity and service, and it carries no points. Charlie Scott is working with two other students, writing and performing an original play for Alzheimer patients.
For me, it was really about broadening my understanding. Undertaking this opportunity has allowed me to gain a better understanding of what it means to play a role in society.
The most important thing is this, the idea of reflection, the fact that because they don't just go and do these activities, they actually do them and then they have to reflect on them and think about what they've learnt from it. So they don't see it, it's sort of service learning, so they don't just see what they can do for other people, they actually think, what has that experience also, what have I got from it as well? So it's a mutual learning.
Nicola is a former student and now works as an accountant at PwC. There were 170 girls in her year. She was one of 18 to take the diploma. She got full marks, which is only achieved by about 1% of students worldwide.
I think everyone was wary a little bit because we didn't know, especially the unis, that was like the next big step, right, getting to university. We didn't know how they were going to take it. But by the time I got there, there were no problems at all. The universities absolutely got it. The school was great, higher development, and we got people in America, you know, everywhere. So it was fine. Yeah, a calculated risk.
Dorothea Beale was the longest serving principal in the college's history. She introduced subjects such as maths and science, despite parental opposition. The college is determined to continue her pioneering approach to education.